Let us understand what our customers want. Now go through the screen. Pause the video for a minute. Proceed to the next screen after done with. We will learn what customers require from organizations. Continuing from the last screen, remember that there are four key attributes which describe the needs of a customer. They are called QCDS: quality, cost, delivery, and service. You should always remember that a customer drives the process. People develop the processes, and hence the focus needs to be on process quality. But first, let us understand the first attribute, the quality. The other three, cost, delivery, and service, are all connected to quality. In quality, we focus on two aspects, the stated needs and the implied needs. Continuing our learning, let us understand what are stated needs. They are one which are actually expressed in terms of concrete words, like I need a table having a length of 20 centimeters. Now this need will be satisfied if I really get the required length. This is a stated need satisfaction. An implied need can be the quality of material used to make a 20 centimeter table, but you're not really satisfied with it. Although it is having the required length, but you are not satisfied with its material or the way you have been treated during purchase or its delivery. Most problems with quality arise from needs that are implied. These are the needs or the promises that are assumed in the mind of the person receiving the product or the service. These needs would have been missed during the stage of quality planning and need to be taken care of during the planning stage itself. Let us come to the second attribute, that is cost. By the term cost, we mean the cost at a competitive price, which a customer is willing to pay. It is the value for money paid or invested by the customer. Value for money is in the perception of the buyer or receiver of goods and or services. Proof of good value for money is in believing or concluding that the goods or services received was worth the price paid. Examples of types of factors that may be considered are suitability, quality, skills, price, whole of the life costs, and other criteria. The mix of these and other factors and the relevant importance of each will vary on a case-to-case basis. Now the third attribute, delivery. By the term delivery, we mean that the delivery of the product or service within the expected timelines. Fast delivery has become a critical factor in building confidence. Firstly, fast deliveries make a ground for repeat purchases and greater customer satisfaction. And secondly, there must be a fine balance between the various inventories, logistics costs, and the profit raised from adding the facility of speedy delivery. Research has proven that in buying online, the concept does not differentiate much in product per se, but in getting instant or very quick gratification, and hence it is an important factor. It is important for quicker gratification for the end customer, but it's not the only thing. Instead, customers need great products and a great service, which is always an add-on for them. Now let us come to the fourth attribute, the attribute of service. This refers to the quality of interaction, communication, and taste. Good customer service is about understanding the needs of different customers, keeping promises, and delivering consistently high standards. It is intended for organizations of all types and sizes, for large corporations to small businesses. For example, it could be used by banks, government departments, retailers, or local traders. Rising customer expectations and the growing trend to share negative experiences online is putting pressure on companies to raise their game. Smart organizations understand that good service is crucial to their success, helping them to keep existing customers and win new ones.